Ой, hello friends, welcome home. It's been 4 years already since I showed you this blin recipe. And it's about time I show you next one. And these are what I like to call the Tsar's blins. Nice and small, but nice and thin. I do not get fascination with thick blin. I want to taste the topping as well. And that is why these are ideal. For eating caviar by the spoonful. And yes, for authentic recipe I have bought actual beluga caviar. Yes, my wallet is screaming at me. And not worry, I'm not giving you the track. I will be making the thick small ones with yeast as well. We begin. Yes, Boris! First, some cajus.
But what is cajus, Boris? I was not warned of this system.
You'll get hang of it. We will need 250 ml. You can see it right here. That is about probably 1 cup. Wait. This cup measurement to another side. I've been using the wrong side all this time. I'm too late to switch now. La 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 la. Have small sample of the juice. Now you can just pour it on the bowl, no problem. But if you want to be difficult like Boris, you warm up the milk beforehand. Completely necessary step at this point, but we want adventure. Now you will actually need to do this if you're making yeast pancakes. So it's, you know, it's good practice if you want to. Now what a complete blin is this? Not the electric stove was bad enough. Shit, now we have to cook with magnets. What is next? What was wrong with cooking with gas? Maybe I want my kitchen warm. Oh, it is warming up. Nice. And about 250 ml of flour as well. No. What are these deviations? These are not Tsar's blin. This is more like Vadim's field experiment. Вот, нормально. Ба-ра-пам-ба-пам. A golden spoonful of sugar. Drop it in. Some salt. Half a teaspoon is fine. Pour in the milk. And we start the mixing procedure. So in case you did not know, blin meets pancake. And blin is also the family friendly version of the word блять. Now we add 2 chicken produce, блять. Mix the блять around some more with butter cooking device. Now remember, the path to consistent quality blends is proper lubrication. Use sunflower seed oil for truly slavic result, or just use butter for truly Boris slavic result. Ha! What are you screaming? I haven't started even cooking yet, блять. Now the butter has melted just a bit. We take a spoonful of dough and very carefully do not let it spread. Pour 3 very small blins. When they start getting darker from the edge, you can flip around. Oba! Nice and light blins. A bit darker from the other side, but this is fine. So as you can see, this is basically transportation device for whatever you put on top. For example, babushkas, jam. Nah, this is too easy. Condensed milk, ah! Ooh, oh, I could eat this all day. And now I add the jam. But sweet blins are so 2015. And some sour cream or сметана. The more fat, the better, trust me. Now this is 30% for true slav man. None of that low fat comedy. And on top, what do you serve the Tsar? Of course, some smoked salmon. But it is not all. If you can afford it, what is this? What is going on here? You're running an experiment! There must be no deviation near the caviar. Add again a healthy dose of sour cream and bring out... What are you trying to keep out of this box? Come on! Опа! I present to you Siberian sturgeon caviar. Equivalent of $1,000 per kilogram. Or about the same amount of money for this small amount that you could spend for a whole month of food. So you take out your spoon and throw it aside. Because you do not touch caviar with a metal spoon. Use special spoon or plastic spoon. But since we clearly spent all our money on caviar, we just used the single-use spoons that I found. And we're done! No lemon, no onion on top. Just plain sour cream and caviar. Let's give them a try. Dessert first, and not the smoked salmon. And not the star of the show. Or, I mean, Tsar of the show. The caviar. Yes. More. Yes, I know what you're asking. And yes, it did taste like a whole week of food. And now for the truly gourmet specialist, you're serving instead, of course, with mayonnaise.
Can't you be open
now? Oh, shit, not again! We continue with the blins. Now add about 150 ml milk. Now you will need some more later on, but I suggest a small amount. Heat up the milk just a bit, which only takes your stove is like 5 seconds. Pour it in the bowl, bring up yeast, about 1 1/2 tablespoon, boom. Mix it around and let it sit for about 10 minutes. This makes the yeast come alive. Now you can choose to hold 250 ml of milk at this point, but since for whatever reason people have a different consistency flour, you might actually end up needing more or less milk. Ah yes, the dry yeast is completely dissolved. It smells like... Ah, yes, smells like babushka's house. Now you will need about 250 ml or flour. Some people ask me what type of flour, Boris. There is just one type of flour, блять. Ага, a bit more. Hey, nice. Now I see some recipes using buckwheat flour. Have you gone completely crazy? Blends are made with wheat flour. Ah, shit, I forgot to add rest of the milk. Ah, how am I supposed to get this out? Who the complete rot designed this? Fucking Vadim Designs Incorporated. You spawn like normal people. Now, as I said, you will need about 100 milliliters more. You're looking for this kind of very thick consistency. And we just leave it to rest for 30 minutes in one of those mythical locations called the warm place, which if you live in Siberia is refrigerator. And BOOM! It just risen to twice the size! Okay, I actually did have to cheat a bit, because it's like 21 degrees indoors for me. So I had to put it in the oven. But if you do it, then please make sure that you put it on minimum heat. Or I should just end up with one big pancake, or oven cake. I think it just goes back to being a normal cake at that point. So I showed you before to use butter, but if you're a bit of a beginner, I suggest you use sunflower seed oil instead, because butter has smoke point at about 150 degrees, which in normal terms just means that you might have a bit more chance of burning your house down. But is it worth it for the just a taste of butter on your blends? Yes. And again, put small bits of dough. Actually, you might have realized that I did not put any eggs or salt inside. Because, you know, caviar, fish eggs, they're salty. I don't know, there's logic somewhere. Just follow the full recipe in the description of this video with accurate measurement. And once they start getting brown at the edges, we flip them around, but not with this inferior tool. Don't call me prepared blend flip champion of 86 for nothing. Shut up! You can do this, Boris, come on, you can do this. 4 instead of 1 is not difference. Boris, blend 360, come on! 2 out of 4, no problem! Completely normal phenomenon, this is Chernobyl all over again. Feel free to serve these blends to your friends, family, relatives, cousins. No, wait, it's the same thing. Whenever you're going to a Russian restaurant, wherever in the world it may be, feel free to ask for blends with caviar. Just do not be surprised to receive fake caviar instead. As a rule of thumb, if the plate cost the equivalent of $50 and there is one spoonful of caviar, then there is a high chance that it is real actual beluga caviar from Caspian Sea, from the actual beluga sturgeon fish. And if the spoonful costs $500, then do not be surprised to find the price of the tables and the chairs included on the bill, because it just got ripped off. Life is good. I'll see you on the next video, and until then, stay chic, bricky. Ah.